Hey, Erin. When you were 3.5 months old, I went back to work full time. And that's when I learned the true meaning of a mother's strength. You probably don't remember watching this back, but this is how I worked full time while you were an infant. And I did it all by myself. When you were 3.5 months old, I went back to work full time. And ever since returning back to work, I wake up before the sun, and you are up. When I initially came back from maternity leave, I wasn't anticipating losing sleep because of work. Ironically enough, I think the last good night of sleep I remember getting was actually the night before I came back to work. Many newborn moms usually say it's their baby's lack of sleep that has them sleep deprived, but I never really had that issue with you. Instead, I find myself waking up earlier and earlier every morning in order to make sure I get all my work done for the day. Some nights, I only sleep for an hour or two, maybe three, if I'm lucky. And some nights, I don't sleep at all and I just work through it. But I do it. And I do it with love. I do it with a smile on my face. And I do it proudly. For you, Erin, each and every day. And in all sincerity, waking up so early isn't something that's new to me. Back when I lived in my studio apartment in Koreatown, I used to wake up at this time so I could catch the bus to go to UCLA. I guess you can say your mom has always been an early bird. So to me, this isn't really a new adjustment as a parent. It just feels, oddly enough, nostalgic. On the harder mornings, the mornings where all I want to do is lay in bed with you, cuddle, and just sleep in together, I tell myself, it won't be like this forever. I'm doing this for now because I love you and I want to give you a life worth living. If I ever find myself still feeling doubtful, I just look over at you sleeping right beside me. And I remind myself I have a little girl who depends on me. And this is a good paying job that helps me live a comfortable life with you. If another single mom or someone else on the internet stumbles upon this video one day, hi, my name is Priscilla, and I found out I was pregnant when I was 26 years old. I was 2 months pregnant when my long-term relationship dissolved. So, I chose to keep my pregnancy. And he chose himself. And ever since then, I've been doing this thing on my own. I'm now 27 years old and 7 months postpartum at the time of filming this video. I don't receive any child support, I never did, and I'm not lucky enough to have a co-parent. But on the bright side, I now have a happy and healthy 7-month-old daughter named Erin, and she's my reason for living. So I wake up every morning with purpose and ambition because of her. This is how I work from home with my infant daughter, Erin. Good morning, everyone. It is currently 2:59 a.m. I'm talking a little bit low because Erin is still sleeping. And I don't want to wake her up because I really want to take advantage of these couple of hours that I have to myself this morning. This is usually the time that I wake up every day since I came back from maternity leave. I'm just like making sure she's not getting disturbed by my voice. I'll also put captions just in case I'm speaking a little bit too low. It's pretty much 3 a.m. This is the start of my work day. I didn't really sleep last night. I was on my phone doing stuff, answering emails, having my me time, making Instagram reels. If you don't follow me on Instagram, you should go check it out. I like kind of vlog my hikes with my daughter on the weekend, and for the new year I started doing like a kind of like a weight loss and health journey vlog series with Instagram reels. So if you want, you can follow me on Instagram. I'll leave my link down below in the description bar. I usually keep it very simple Monday through Friday for like my morning routine, just because I don't want to waste any precious time. I'm going to take my vitamins this morning, just a multivitamin. These aren't the ones I usually take. I think I picked up the wrong ones at Target, but I love this brand. It's my favorite vitamin brand from the drugstore.
And I'm just gonna take it really quickly with my coffee. And then something that I like to do to just kind of like wake me up, I like to do this little eye mask because, oh my God, I had prenatal insomnia when I was pregnant, and I definitely have postpartum anxiety, and one of my biggest symptoms is insomnia. So I know I have really crazy eye bags a lot of the time, especially when I don't sleep a lot during the week. So I picked these up. I think they will help me. I really like this Hero brand. So I'm just gonna pop these on really quickly. I just did my nighttime routine a couple hours ago before I started, you know, getting on my phone doing like my little reels. So I still kind of have my retinol and my moisturizer from literally maybe 2 hours ago. I'm not gonna do any moisturizer, maybe in a little bit. After I answer some emails, I will do it. For now, I'll just do these eye patches.
Becoming a single full-time working mom has been humbling, to say the least. I have a new appreciation for every day that I'm able to wake up and make the best out of my circumstances and just figure it out as I go. If I did not know why I existed before or what exactly I was working towards in my past life, well, I do now. In the last few months, as I've been finding my groove around working from home with Erin, my goals have adjusted and realigned themselves. I am living to reach my short-term goals with Erin, but I'm still breathing to achieve my long-term goals with her too. And now that I'm in the thickness of raising an infant, I am finding my footing. Slowly but surely. I take it one day at a time. I start off my mornings with absolutely no expectations, and I don't go into each day with too much confidence because what worked in getting me through the day yesterday, that may not work for me today. And what worked in getting me through the week last week may not work for me this week. The baby I was raising a month ago is not the same baby I'm raising today. And this is something I remind myself, especially recently when I've been having harder days. And this friendly reminder, it has really been helping my mental health from deteriorating. And I won't lie, being a single mother is hard, especially a working single mom. It's hard. But I love my daughter so much. I always have. So no matter how difficult and trying the days may be at times, I remind myself, I am only being this hard on myself right now because of how much I love my daughter. I want to be the best version of me as a mother, even on my worst days, on my rougher days, because this is the path I chose, and this is where I want to be, what I want to be doing. Waking up this early every day, it may not look glamorous to you, but I can assure you it's fulfilling, and it's the most rewarding work that I have ever done in my life. Why? Well, because I have my daughter cheering me on every second of the day to just try my best. Even when I fuck up, she still loves me.
So I sneezed and I accidentally woke Erin up. It's currently a little bit after 4 a.m. So I'm just gonna make her a bottle really quickly just to see if maybe she's hungry before I try to get her back to bed for a few more hours because it's still pretty early. Oops. Okay, let's shake it first. So I just made her a bottle. I'm gonna put her back down to take another nap until she usually sleeps until 7:30, 8. She woke up pretty late in the pretty late. She usually wakes up around 2, 3, but it's actually a little bit after 4. So I'm pretty surprised because I was making a lot of noise actually. But yeah, I'm gonna try to get her back down. I don't really keep track of how long it takes me to settle her back down into sleep. But it shouldn't take more than 30 minutes, I want to say. And then that way I could keep on working. Come on, Erin. Say bye. Say goodbye.
Sleepy time, lovey. She loves the camera. Every time she sees a camera, she knows. No, Erin, it's sleepy time, Mama. It's sleepy time. I know. She has risen. She is awake. She is awake. It's almost 8 a.m. It's around 7:45-ish. And she's finally awake. This is usually what she likes to do is, I don't know, start doing parkour. Nah, she wants the camera now. Hello, hello. Good morning, good morning. It is almost 8 o'clock. This is usually around the time Erin does wake up. So now that she's up, the fun can finally get started. This is where shit gets real for the rest of the day. But for now, I'm just having her on the floor. I'm gonna just fix my bed, clean things up around here, and I just wanna see how long she lets me work at my desk. She has a really hard time seeing me work at my desk on a chair. I think she feels like ignored, or like she's not getting attention. So she starts freaking out. She like will get under my desk and like start crying at my feet. It's really, really like heartbreaking. So I just wanna see how long she'll let me do that for. And then usually that's when I really have to like start getting creative with the day. But for right now, she's just hanging out, crawling around. I usually let her crawl around like this on the floor, and I'll leave the door open so she can even get into the hallway, and just make sure it's like it's barricaded so she can't like fall down the stairs. There she goes, destroying things. but I just do that, especially today, because I have a couple of meetings this morning. So I try to time things out so that she can fall asleep by the time I have these
calls. I have a really important one with my director for my department at 9:30. I think it's 9 or 9:30. I have to check my calendar again. I'm like blanking right now. But one of those two times, I just know it's before 10. And really important, it's a very interactive call. It's not just a call that I can stay on mute for. Maybe I could stay on mute. It depends on what the call. It's just sort of like weekly meetings where we just touch base and we ask questions about our workflow and working instructions and everything to do with what we do on a day-to-day basis. We just go over things, have refreshers and stuff like that. So who knows? I might have a question. I might have a comment to make. I may get asked something. Something may get, one of my studies may get brought up. So there is a chance I would have to go unmute. Those are the type of calls that I get the most anxious about ever since coming back to work, because especially in the recent weeks. Because now that Erin is, you know, reaching so many milestones so quickly, like back to back to back, she's very babbly, she's a very happy baby, and she loves to talk when she's excited or happy, or she's just very vocal nowadays. So I just don't know what kind of mood I'm gonna have her in if she is awake. So that's another fear of mine. So that's why I just let her do her thing. As soon as she wakes up, I'll go crawl, get all that energy out, and I try to have her take her first nap around the time, if not at the same time that I'm doing my first call. Fingers crossed though, the last 2 weeks, it's been working. They've been getting timed like very well, and I've been able to have my meetings with her asleep and has stayed asleep throughout the whole meet. Like, my meetings aren't extremely long. They're about an hour, hour and a half long. But the past 2 weeks, it's something like the universe has been aligning, and we have been able to like get her to like take a nap, even if it's a 15 minute nap, just so I can get like my portion like done in these calls. And it's been such a lifesaver. So I'm just keeping my fingers crossed for today. Who knows? She might be awake for the whole call and she just might be really quiet. And I might be freaking out the whole call. Who knows? Who knows? We don't know. Every day is a unknown, uncharted territory, working from home with an infant baby. So I'm just putting out good vibes and good energy out there to see like what we can do today. Especially today, since I'm showing you guys like what our routine is usually like. So fingers crossed.
Being a single mom who works full-time from home has taught me the true definition of multitasking, and that it is possible to kill two birds with one stone. We single parents really do make the impossible possible. And being a working parent, the breadwinner in the family, everything in our day-to-day life just seems so much more heavier and important than it probably ever was. Even the mundane things like cleaning. If I don't take time to clean, I feel like a bad mom. In my mind, a good mom, she makes time to clean. And if I have time to go get my eyebrows done, then I have time to vacuum my daughter's room. And if I have time to get an eyelash fill, then I have time to fix the laundry, which I still haven't done. And on the days where work has me completely tied to the computer, that's when I feel like the worst mom on earth. I feel neglectful. And I try to remind myself how much of a superwoman I actually am on those occasions, and that it is okay to cut myself some slack. I'm doing this all on my own with no help. There's no babysitter, there's no nanny, no co-parent, there's no one, just myself. It's myself getting me through the days right now. No one but myself and, oh yeah, myself and my daughter Erin. We're the team getting us through the days. And I pour into her and she pours into me. When I replay all of my adulthood so far in my head, and I go over all the trials and tribulations I have experienced throughout the last few years, I distinctly remember never letting myself make excuses as to why I still couldn't do or achieve my goals. When I was the sickest I had ever been, and I had so many bills, I worked the most unglamorous jobs just so that I could continue moving forward. And I did it, all on my own. So to me, there is no such thing as the phrase, I can't. That's loser language. And my parents didn't raise no loser. and I'm not raising my daughter to ever utter the words "I can't." I want her to know where there's a will, there is a way. And if she feels she won't be able to accomplish something on her own, that's what I'm here for. And when you become a single parent, your goals and your ambitions in life, they become second to your child. They become harder to reach. But even now, with things being twice as complicated, it still doesn't feel impossible. They're just harder to obtain. But that doesn't mean I am just gonna give up or start slacking off out of self-pity just because things are harder. I can't, and I won't. I refuse. Oh my God, is that me using loser language? My daughter's childhood is on the line. That's what I always have sitting in the back of my mind. And I have been her source of stability, of warmth, of love, of happiness. I won't allow anyone to jeopardize her stability, not even myself. I'm not playing when it comes to my daughter, and not now and not ever. So if I have to go days without sleeping so that I can keep my job, I will. I will do it today, tomorrow, the day after that, and every day after that. I made sacrifices for my daughter since day one because I knew being her mom was gonna be worth it. So no matter how tired, haggard, unattractive I may seem to a stranger watching this back, I don't care. I know what I contribute towards every day, and that is worth more to me than my appearances, especially as a mom to a daughter. Being pretty, unfortunately, doesn't pay my bills, and I kind of never want that to be the case.
Okay, so we're pretty much done with the really important part of the morning, which is making sure that the room is as clean as possible. We will be up here for a few more hours before we get to go downstairs, and I'll go work from downstairs for a little bit. But it's really important for me to vacuum every single morning just because Erin is fully mobile. She is in full crawl mode. So because she's crawling, I just want to make sure the floor is clean so she doesn't get dirty or she doesn't pick up anything like sus. And it's just a good habit I have. I feel like it's a good habit to just like vacuum the room every day. I'm pretty sure that's what everyone does. And I just have her, I also have the stair. I also have like the staircase barricaded just in case. And I do leave my door open now that she is in crawling mode, just because I know it could be very like suffocating to be stuck in a closed environment. I could imagine what it's like for a baby. So yeah. I'm probably gonna, now that I'm done vacuuming, I'm probably gonna unbaby wear her so she can crawl a little bit more and get that energy out of her. And hopefully we could time it a little bit right and she could be asleep for a majority of my phone call this morning. Knowing my luck, she will not go to sleep during like before the call or even during the call. We will have to figure it out. But we'll see. We'll see. I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows?
Mommy needs her glasses. I can't see.
Thank you.
So it is currently 9:09. My meeting is actually at 9:30. I just looked over my calendar when I hopped back on the computer and I confirmed 9:30 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So I'm hoping she falls asleep within the next 10 minutes, 10, 20 minutes. She's tired, I could tell. This is usually what happens right before my meeting days. My meeting days are usually like stacked meetings back to back in the morning. So this is usually what happens around this time. She'll eat and I'll be baby wearing her, and I'll be trying my best to multitask. Even though technically this is my first break of the day, I have like an hour and a half gap. But the agreement was with my HR that that is acceptable to take my hour and a half gap to, like, you know, feed her, take care of her, on days that I do not have required meetings to attend to. So on the days that I have required meetings, I have to kind of improvise, and my schedule is kind of like up in the air. Pretty much the agreement was with my supervisors and my HR was that as long as I'm available when I say I'm available, so basically if my team's light is my team status is saying online, then they're gonna assume that I'm on the computer, you know, working. So that's one of the things I've had to start being very vigilant about, is just changing my status. If I'm busy, I put it on red and they kind of know that I'm busy. They know that if I use the away status, that means that I'm probably on one of my breaks for the day. That's one of the things that I'm extremely grateful when it comes to my job. I didn't know that they were even going to give me this flexibility till the month I was supposed to come back to work. We had a meeting like 2 weeks prior to my return date that I had originally given them before I went on maternity leave. And so I had a meeting one day with my supervisor, and, you know, I got really lucky. They offered to give me a flex schedule. It wasn't something that I asked for. I was scared to ask for one. I'm just not good at those type of conversations. I'm not good at negotiating my salary. I've never done that before. So please don't listen. Like, I'm not the person to go to for advice when it comes to like this type of career stuff, because I've never even negotiated my own salary. I'm scared to, like, those type of conversations make me uncomfortable. So, like, asking for something like a flex schedule fresh out of maternity leave, I just thought that with the type of job I have, it's pretty demanding. So, and, like, very, like, timeline, deadline driven. So I didn't think that that would even be a thing. I thought that I would have to kind of, like, figure things out, or, like, I know this is, like, really bad to say, but, like, kind of, like sneak around the fact that I have an infant at home. But, no, they're very well aware. They're very well aware that I have Erin at home with me. And as the months have gone by since I came back to work, those gaps that I was given, because they kind of asked me, like, hey, like, think about it. What do you want, like, your flex schedule to be? And we'll talk to your other supervisors, my directors that I work with, and see if it's, like, doable, or, like, what we can do. And so I just, like, came up with, like, a random schedule. I was taking into consideration her feeding schedule at that time and, like, how I was pumping. But, you know, that time came and went. I'm no longer pumping. She's no longer breastfeeding full time. She has started to kind of want to latch again, so I have been trying with her. But yeah, so that schedule was, like, really good at the very beginning. Like, maybe the first month and a half that I came back to work, it was, like, a really good schedule. I was actually using it appropriately. But now that I'm back into the full swings of what my job, like, really entails, my meeting's about to start. But now that I'm back into the swing of things, and it's been, I think I've been back at work for about 5 months now. Yeah, I've been back at work for almost 5 months now. And even on days that I don't have meetings, I typically don't even take my gap breaks like that. Like, I don't, unless, like, I really, like, just need to, like, get away from the computer. Like, I really do need a break to, like, get something done with Erin, or she's being extra fussy on a certain day. Yeah, then I will use, like, my full gap period. But typically I'm online pretty much all the time, as long as, like, Erin allows me to be. It really depends on her mood, like, what my workflow is like every single day. So, like, no 2 days, even with this, like, set flex schedule, are my days alike. So yeah, so hopefully you caught us on a good day and this meeting goes well. This meeting is with my boss that I'm, like, really, like, scared of. I'm not scared of, but I'm, like, you know, like, she's one of those bosses that really makes me, like, flustered, because I don't want to, like, mess up in front of her or say the wrong thing. I want to be on my A game with this boss. So yeah, she's got those tired eyes, so we'll see. I'm hoping she does fall asleep for this meeting because I would like to take a seat. My legs are killing me. But if not, then I'll just wait until later when we go downstairs and I can work on the couch. I'll thug it out for now, but yeah, my meeting's gonna start in about 15 minutes. That was like my reminder notice. It's almost 9:30. So yeah, so far so good. I'm pretty surprised. Every time I've tried to film the three other occasions, it's been chaos. So this is how she gets when she's trying to fall asleep. So I always get so nervous because it happens right before a call or like at the beginning of a call, like she hasn't fallen asleep sometimes and I start freaking out. I'm about to break into sweats because even if it's a call that I don't need to like particularly like chime in, like I always end up making a comment or two, and this is like more like of a team building type of meeting, so I'm pretty sure I will have to speak at some point, even if it's just to say hello, hi guys. So I always get scared that they're gonna hear her like groaning in the back. So I'm gonna work my magic within the next 15 minutes and I am gonna rock her to bed or rock her to sleep for her nap. And this will be considered her first nap of the day. It's usually not that long. I don't know. I've been getting lucky lately where she sleeps for the duration of the call and like somehow miraculously she wakes up like right after like we all hang up on Teams. So we'll see.
There are small wins throughout the day, each and every day, where I realize time and time again, oh yeah, this is so worth it. And it's the most insignificant things too. Like when Erin successfully takes her first nap of the day, the feeling of relief and just relishing in the quietness is just so satisfying and rewarding all at the same time. Being able to type my fingers away as fast as I can, it really is the race against Erin's 45-minute naps. It turns into a fun game of how many emails can I send out before she wakes up? Or I can take advantage right now and call my boss up and ask her all the questions I need to get out of the way without worrying about Erin interrupting the call. Or I can finally focus and review all these open inquiries at my own pace with no interruptions. It's wins like that throughout each and every work day that just makes the days just so much more enjoyable outside of being Erin's mom. I have unintentionally found ways to make those overstimulating situations a bit of a comedic relief for myself. Whether Erin is asleep or awake, sometimes I don't think there is much of a difference because everything still ends up revolving around her. It's like a never-ending game that I'm not really sure I want out of, but I would like to pause it for a second so that I can go to the bathroom. But somehow I can't bring myself to put the controller down completely. I think there's a preconceived notion when it comes to being a single mom. Even sitting here telling you all of this, I know there's going to be a group of people who will find this video and think, here she goes again. Woe is me. Who told you to keep your pregnancy? Who told you to keep your pregnancy? You thought it was going to make him stay? Well, now look at you. You had a choice and you obviously didn't make the right choices. And that's why you're sitting here now acting like you're some sort of victim. But in reality, you forced him into the situation. Why does he have to pay you child support? Why does he have to help you? He told me you lied to him about being on birth control. Why don't you go find a boyfriend who's gonna help you raise your daughter? Oh yeah, that's right. No one wants to deal with all of that. So why don't you go hold your L and stop nagging him over paying child support? Maybe if it was someone else who got pregnant and not you, him and his family would be more than happy to help. Those were things that I was recently told when I was reaching out for help. I needed help. I was at my breaking point. And nowadays, I just have those conversations playing on loop in my head, whether it's a good day at work or a bad day. I don't necessarily even think they're intrusive thoughts at this point. I think it's just my subconscious reminding me why I'm going so hard. Those were real things that were said to a postpartum mother. And working from home in hindsight, it sounds ideal, right? Especially as a single mom who either wants to save money that they would otherwise be spending on a very expensive daycare or babysitter, or because they don't have much of a village. It sounds like it's killing two birds with one stone, and that's honestly what I thought when I was preparing to come back to work. I thought it would be easy because all my baby was doing was just sleeping and eating and pooping. But boy, was I naive. Maybe when they're still a newborn, things are more doable. But once Erin started reaching milestones like crawling, standing, and walking, it seemed almost impossible when you're actively attempting to do both parenting and working from home simultaneously. It doesn't get easier as they grow and develop more autonomy. It becomes a difficult juggling act that can start to wear you down both physically, but more importantly, emotionally and mentally. Some days when I'm busier than others and I can't seem to catch a break, I can feel what overstimulation truly is to my core. I hadn't experienced it in early postpartum, but now that I'm almost 6 months back at work, especially closer to the end of last year, I started to experience overstimulation as a postpartum mother. And it was scary because I didn't even know what I could do to bring myself back down to baseline. And I was just home alone with Erin. I would worry that she could feel my anxiety skyrocketing, and I would just start to feel so guilty because I was overwhelmed and there was nothing I could do. It's tough. It's like how I said earlier, how everything in life for a parent doesn't automatically just become unobtainable. They just become harder tasks or goals to reach. I remember towards the end of last year, I started experiencing postpartum depression. I was having a hard time at work, making really, really, really obvious and stupid mistakes that costed actual money. And I was also struggling at home with Erin because she was sick. And during this time period, I thought I was going to lose my job, and it had me in a panic for weeks. I would end my workday in tears out of frustration with myself. And I caught myself wondering, Priscilla, what are you going to do if you lose your job? What are you going to do? It got to such a dark place for me that I was even having ideations because, like, I felt like such a failure both to my job but ultimately to my daughter. And I got so desperate and concerned for my daughter's livelihood that I went asking her own father for help. But I just got shut down. Instead, I just got threatened to have my daughter taken from me because I was asking for child support, thinking it would help pay for a babysitter to come at least once a week. That way, I could get some support at home. But instead, I just ended up being dismissed. And it wasn't a good feeling. I think because of the things that replay in my head, they truly believe that I don't deserve the proper support as a single mom. And since that time period, I have found my groove again, at least for the time being when it comes to balancing both work and Erin at home. For now, this routine is what works for me. And I pray and I talk to God throughout my workday or whenever I feel myself needing the additional support. And I think it was finding some sort of spirituality since the start of the new year that's really helped me keep me grounded as a mother. It has helped me continue working towards the light at the end of the tunnel. And I don't take anti-anxiety medication anymore. So I think that is also for the better. I don't think it was doing much for me anyways. I think nowadays, even when I feel myself getting overwhelmed throughout my moments in my day, I just keep my daughter close to me. It's something about her innocence that makes all of my worries and doubts just drift away. Erin has no idea how much she's turned my world upside down in the best way possible.
Hey guys, so I just got off my meeting. We went a little bit over the time. It's usually an hour long from 9:30 to 10:30. But in the middle of the call, she started to get really fussy, and I took her out of her baby carrier because I realized she had to do poopies. So she did poopies And so I had to change her diaper. Luckily, like, my other coworker, who has kind of a different workflow than me, was discussing something with her boss. So they were kind of going back and forth for a little bit. Didn't really have any input to give anyways because it doesn't pertain to my workflow. So I took advantage of that and I just changed her and just kept myself on mute and everything went well. And then I just kept her off the baby carrier, and she's been underneath my desk, and you can kind of hear her now. She does get fussy when she sees you sitting at the desk. I think she feels like she's being ignored. I could be wrong, but that's kind of how I take it as, because she gets really upset after a while, like, if you're not, like, giving her attention. And it happens every time when I'm, like, sitting at the desk or even standing. She'll, like, get right at my feet, and she'll, like, you know, start playing with my toes or whatever, or my socks, and then she'll, you know, start getting a little bit more fussy and needy, and that's my cue to get off the computer and attend to her needs and stuff. But we're actually gonna go move ourselves downstairs. I think that's enough of working at my desk in my room. I don't have a dedicated workspace or another big screen downstairs for me to just hook my laptop to, so it's beneficial to go downstairs and work for the rest of the day after, like, a busy morning, because Erin has all her toys downstairs. There's more space. There's, like, two living rooms, and it's just free range for her, and then I can just sit on the couch. The only downside is, though, it's not my favorite part of the day, because working off of one screen when you have, like, a very, like, you have to multitask. When you have a job that requires you to multitask and do, like, several things at the same time, or you need to, like, have several things open at the same time, it's really hard. And I'm blind, so I definitely need to wear my glasses when I just work off on my laptop. It's not even a big screen on my laptop, and I haven't really requested a portable attachable screen, because I know they do have those on Amazon. I just never asked for it because it wasn't a thing until recently. Now that Erin is around and she's mobile and stuff. But I think I'm going to take my break now, because my original break, my flex schedule break, is that I take a 1.5 hour break from 8:30 a.m. to 10, because that was kind of what I was doing while I was, like, still, like, breastfeeding and pumping. And she was more like a very, she was eating more frequently, I guess I could say, I think. Not frequently, but I don't know. It just took longer to, like, you know, takes longer to breastfeed and, yeah, stuff like that. So but not so much now, because she can hold her own bottle, so I don't necessarily need to take breaks, because she can eat on the swing while I still work. So I never really take the full hour and a half. On days like this where I have, like, back-to-back meetings in the morning, or it's just a very hectic morning, I usually don't take my first break. I usually will take it after my very last meeting of the morning. And then I probably will do an hour and a half, especially since I've been up pretty much all night just working through the night. I definitely do need a break. I feel like I'm dissociating. Like, I'm so, you ever been so, like, sleep deprived, you just feel like you're having, like, an outer body experience? It's kind of how I feel right now. So I'm going to make us some breakfast, probably some eggs. She is eating solids. She already had her bottle. So perfect time to, like, give her, like, a brunch. So I gotta go. She's had enough. But she was fine for the duration of, like, for the rest of the call. She was fine. She was playing with her teething toys. She was playing with my toes. She was, like, tickling me. But now it is time for us to relocate downstairs. Okay, I'm coming. Hey guys, so we're still upstairs after my meeting. We didn't end up going downstairs just because she seems pretty chill on the carrier right now, and I really just want to get as much work as I can done on my big screen, because it just helps multitasking through different windows so much more easier compared to if I was just downstairs with just the laptop. I also changed. I was, like, profusely starting to sweat. I can't really take a shower as I don't have anyone to wash her. So that's a no-go, but I did change her into, like, a really cute outfit for the remainder of the day. I'm pretty sure she's gonna get dirty, so I don't want to put her in anything too cute, like a really cute outfit. I save those for, like, when you're, like, gonna go out for the day or something like that. But I just tried to do her hair, and now she's just chilling in the carrier with me. I'm pretty sure, I think around lunchtime,
I'll say like maybe 12, we'll head downstairs and we'll make something for us both to eat together. But for now, I'm just gonna take advantage that she seems really chill. Or maybe I spoke too soon. While I was taking care of her, she scratched my forehead, so I have a new accessory to rock for the remainder of the video. When she's like really like, she's sleepy, but she's just not falling asleep. So I'm hoping maybe if she's on the carrier sitting down with me for a little bit longer, she'll start to fall asleep on her own. She's not hungry or anything, but she's just a little like, she's a little restless. So when she gets like that, she starts to scratch her face, and then she started scratching my face. So that's how I got my little war scar now on my forehead. Yeah, so that's the plan. I'm just gonna take it 15 minutes at a time. You know how people say, oh, take it 1 hour at a time, take it day by day. No, we're taking it 15 minutes at a time. So we may deviate from this. We may end up upstairs all day, who knows. But I am hungry. I'm tired, for sure tired. I don't know if you could tell. I look like a battered woman now with my little scratches. But yeah, I'm hoping she can take a nap, just because if she skips this morning nap, I'm kind of scared for how the late afternoon is gonna go, honestly. Because a few times she has skipped her morning naps, it's been pretty bad. It's been brutal in the afternoons. So yeah, I'm keeping my fingers crossed. So I'm just gonna keep letting her watch Miss Rachel. I think this is also, you know what, I think it's another great idea if we just stay upstairs, because I have the TV right here. So while I'm on the computer, she can kind of look over at Miss Rachel, and that keeps her like very occupied. Thank God for Miss Rachel. It is what it is. It is what it is. I'm trying not to get worked up. I'm like flustered and anxious, but sometimes it's really hard. I don't know. Sometimes I feel like I confuse being overwhelmed with overstimulation, because I know that's a big thing in postpartum. I don't know if I feel overstimulated. I just feel overwhelmed when life hits me, and I recognize that I can't multitask with her. Sometimes I have to like pick one or the other. So yeah, but we're gonna have a good day. We're gonna make it a good day. I know it'll be a good day. She let me do her hair. I was trying to do her hair and she let me do it, so that's a plus. And now her hair is brushed out and it's not all matted in the back, because it's still kind of short there. But yeah, I got to do her hair, so that's a win. So she actually just fell asleep. I'm low-key so excited that I changed. Like, I changed from my pajamas to like comfortable clothing. And then I got the chance to do her hair and change her a little bit, because I don't know, I just feel a lot better that she fell asleep like this. I'm not gonna put her down. I'm just gonna keep her on my carry-on. I'm doing pretty fine just like this, so I'm not gonna like do anything to try and risk waking her up. I have a couple things that came up, and so I have to take care of that. I would love to actually take time right now to like make breakfast with her asleep like this on me, but I don't know. My gut is telling me to just finish and take care of what I have on my dashboard right now, and then worry about eating later, especially since she's asleep. A couple of things just popped up on my dashboard that I kind of should just take care of now, because I have a feeling by the time she wakes up, it's going to be like early afternoon-ish, and I'm going to be stuck downstairs for the rest of the day. So it's just really nice having my big monitor to like do everything at, with my standing desk, because I can still baby wear her like this and have her asleep. I'm hoping she sleeps for at least like 45 minutes. I don't know what's been going on with her the last month or two, but her sleep, her wake windows are getting longer, which is great. She's growing and she's reaching more milestones, but her naps are getting shorter. And I'm trying to also do a bit of sleep training with her, but like getting her to have long wake windows and like maybe an hour or two of nap times, like two naps in the day, like it's really, really hard. Some days she's able to just take two naps. Some days she's still taking three naps, which is great because it gives me a little bit more time to like type away on the computer. But I would like to sleep train her so it helps with her nighttime sleeping and just helps me figure out how I can kind of get a new routine going on for with her in this like new stage of baby infancy. But not a big deal. I'm just gonna take advantage now while I can and just get stuff figured out and taken care of before I head downstairs for my next gap break. One last thing. I know this is like not in like a fucked up way, but like I don't know if any mom feels like this, but I'm so happy she's asleep because I could finally turn off Miss Rachel. I love Miss Rachel to death. She is a lifesaver. She has changed the game for the work from home mommy community. But oh my God, hearing it nonstop for hours at a time while you're like overwhelmed, overstimulated, going through the motions of, you know, caring for a baby and working at the same time, it can drive someone insane. So I'm just happy that I can have, even if it's 30 minutes, to just listen to one of my favorite podcasts on the TV while I work. Something that I find enjoyable, or just play like one of my favorite YouTubers on the TV and just like, that's like the nicest like pick me up for me while I'm working. It's always been one of my favorite things to do, is just to like pop on like the video version of a podcast on the big screen and just like work from home that way. I've been doing it for years and I love it. And ever since I went back to work, I slowly have had to incorporate more and more time of Miss Rachel on the TV. And as amazing as she is for what she's done for a lot of moms like me, or stay-at-home moms too, oh my God, it just drives me a little bit insane. Like I'm tired of hearing, go to sleep. I just wanted to like get that out. I don't know if it's just me, because I'm still 27, still relatively still young, so I have like that in me still. I don't know if that's selfish to say that I'm just so happy I could turn off Miss Rachel for a little bit, because she does drive me a little bit insane. I don't know. Does that make me a bad mom for saying that? Like, I love Miss Rachel for my daughter, but I want to listen to a podcast or something, or play something I want to listen to.
Trophies, literally, oh God. Anyways, she did a whole panel about all the different anime-themed or anime collaborations in recent months, or even around the convention center and in Southern California, which was very cool, and a bunch of places that I would actually go and check out, the new fun little collaborations and things like that. And then we tried to go to another panel last night because we thought it would be good. We tried to...
And then, of course, we want to practice our raucous applause and cheers. So on the count of three, one,
did you hear Bonnie's back crack?
And then we sat down, they started, and Chris and Anna are like, you're going to get...
Say hi! I just woke up.
I know you're not going to like this. Now,
who is that beautiful girl up there? She looks
that.
Just like my
we
daughter.
Left after like 5 minutes. It was voice acting on stage.
And her name is Erin too, just like you. Say hi. Say hi, I'm awake and I'm recharged and it only took 42 minutes. 42 minutes. Let's go make some food. I'm hungry. And I know you're hungry too. Take mommy's phone for the recipe.
If I had been able to go and like probably take a nap and then go there, that I could go to the...
I just heard another email come through, but I'm gonna ignore it. And I'm just gonna take my first break of the day. I wanna make her some... just heard. I think it was another email notification. I'm gonna ignore it. Thank you. Oh, no, no, no.
Since returning to work, every day I make sure to enjoy breakfast with you, or at least one meal together. And sometimes, well, a lot of the times, like today, I don't always make the most appetizing food for you. But I remember last year when I was pregnant with you, I mentioned in one of my older videos to you that I wanted to always enjoy breakfast together. I think I might have even overpromised to learn how to make the best tasting pancakes in the world. Well, I'm still working on that promise. I'm just not a natural in the kitchen. Although it is enjoyable being in the kitchen a little bit more now since you're around, but it does also add a level of pressure because I want you to grow big and strong, and I feel compelled to make like the healthy almond mom version of everything for you. But don't ever forget, just because something is healthy doesn't mean it always tastes yummy or delicious. I think we both learned that lesson the day that I made these healthy pancakes for you. They tasted like shit, and they looked awful. So, at least pretend that you enjoyed them, please.
Erin?
And even when I do get to enjoy one-to-one time with you throughout my workday, I feel like I'm never completely enjoying the moment with you. Oftentimes, I just feel guilty because in the back of my mind, I'm worried about my emails and everything I need to get done once we finish eating. And then the big question, will I be able to get my work done by the end of the day so I could get some extra sleep tonight? And I'm not gonna lie, I'm a bit jealous of all the stay-at-home moms now. I would love to make being a mom just my full-time and only job. I can only dream of the day that I become so successful I won't ever have to worry as much as I do now. And I can't wait until I have more free time to just enjoy moments with you a little bit more, especially while you're still so little. I have a good feeling in my heart, though, that I'll be able to fulfill my desire to you as a mom pretty soon. For now, I try to enjoy the quiet moments between you and me like this, where we can both pretend mommy's cooking is amazing. Every day is just another day where you grow bigger and you do something new and become a little bit more independent. And sooner enough, you won't be attached to the hip to me like this. That's why no matter how overwhelmed I am throughout the day with juggling multiple hats, I never complain. I try to do everything with the biggest smile on my face because you deserve that much from me.
bit later. So Erin just fell asleep. After we finished eating, I took her a quick shower, and I just changed her into some like cute clean clothes for the rest of the day. And then I gave her her bottle, and now she's asleep. She has days where she will sleep for 2 hours. She has days where she'll sleep for 15, 20, 30 minutes. 30 minutes if I'm lucky. So I want to do my makeup so badly, or at least clean my face. I feel like it'll make me feel better considering Erin left me with like scratches on my face. But honestly, I don't even know if I want to risk it. Because I could honestly be working, that I just, I don't know. I'm just overwhelmed right now because there's so much to do. I still have a whole bunch of dishes to clean, but I don't want to make any noise right now because she's actually asleep on the couch. I kind of have her like barricaded. She just knocked out. I'm just gonna probably work on my laptop, clean my face. Yeah, it's blueberry for sure, right? Yeah, it's blueberry. Yeah, I kind of just want to do something for myself, like just like do my makeup, because I know when I do my makeup, it kind of like puts me in a better mood. Well, not that it puts me in a better mood, but it just makes me feel like put together, like I have my shit together. And right now I just feel like I don't have anything together. It's hard working from home with an infant. It's hard, and it's not easy. Sometimes I feel like there's like something in my chest right here, like I can't breathe, because it's overwhelming. And one thing I will say is that the days, they do go by quicker because there is no minute to like kind of like, I'm kind of on go, trying to do as much as I can. But I feel a little bit not burnt out, just like, I feel like every day I grow a little bit more disappointed with myself because it's just like, I feel like I shouldn't be struggling because I'm still relatively young. I should have the energy, but it's hard. I don't want to start crying, but it's hard. I feel bad even like complaining about struggling working from home with Erin because I'm very privileged in a lot of ways compared to other single moms. I'm very privileged, and I always think about that. And at the end of the day, I always try to tell myself when I get emotional like this that, like, I signed up for this. I knew what I was getting myself into. I just didn't think. I just thought I was gonna have. I just needed to catch my breath for a second. I don't wanna cry with my daughter over there. I just thought at this point in time I would have. I would have more support or more help. I don't get child support, and I'm never gonna get child support. I closed the child support case that I had opened up 3 weeks after Erin was born, and I thought that would help me get some help. Like hire my cousin to help me, because I also don't want to take advantage of my family and have them doing things like helping me raise my daughter for free, because man, I mean, it's hard. People deserve to get compensated for this type of work. It's not just changing diapers and making bottles. It's very emotionally and, of course, physically draining. And this is just the beginning. My daughter's only 7 months. But I thought by now I would at least have that type of help. I don't have it, and I was never gonna get it. I technically could get a babysitter right now, but I talked about this in my postpartum anxiety video, that I really want to buy a house for my daughter for her first birthday, and her birthday's in a couple of months, so I'm saving any and all money that I can, because I know that when I move out into my own home with my daughter, which is coming really, really soon, I'll have enough money saved up for a babysitter, because at that point in time I will be alone. I won't be living with grandma, you know, I won't have my sister here, I won't have any family where I'm planning on moving to, so I know that I'm gonna need a dedicated babysitter. So I'm saving for that, and I'm saving for an expensive one, so that's why now I'm just trying to thug it out. I really am. I'm just trying to like push through and just take it 15 minutes at a time. I'm taking it in like that small of increments. Because I worry that I'm going to fall into postpartum depression. And my mom's already concerned because my workload has only been increasing, obviously. And it's good because I get paid very well. And I have great benefits that I don't want to be in the position of losing everything that I've worked so hard for. So my mom does get concerned sometimes because she sees how I am by the end of the day when she comes home. And, you know, some days are rough. Some days are really, really rough. And I feel defeated. Some days are really great. Some days I feel like I can conquer the world. But there are some days, not every day is bad and not every week is bad. There's some really great weeks, 5 days straight, where I can work from home in bliss and peacefulness. And there's other weeks where there's a day or two out of the week where it really messes me up emotionally as a mother. I'm just like trying my best. With the cards that I've been dealt with, and I don't want to complain too much or seem like woe is me, because I'm not the first or the last single mom, and there's single moms, that's what I always think about too, is like there's single moms out there working 2 and 3 jobs on top of having a baby, an infant or a newborn baby. It's hard. It's really hard. And I always try to remind myself, Erin's a really good baby. I got a very well, like, her demeanor and her, I guess, like, her disposition naturally since she's been born is very chill. She's a very chill baby. But, like, every other baby, she has her moments, and she's only growing, and she's going through so many milestones one after another that, you know, yeah, there are some days where she doesn't want to take shit from me, and, you know, she has her moods, and rightfully so. She's a baby. But yeah, I thought I would take the time to kind of talk to you guys before I get back into the swing of things. It's been about 9 minutes, so if I'm lucky, I feel like she's gonna be asleep for a while. I think I timed everything really well today, especially since she didn't really take much of a morning nap. She only took like, I think it was like 42 minutes, we said. So yeah, I would love to do my makeup and get this blueberry. I need to wash my face again and get the blueberry out of my forehead. I think that's blueberry. It's mostly this. I just look like a battered woman going through it. And not that that's funny or anything, but I just look like I'm going through it with how disheveled I kind of look like. And when my hair is just naturally like this, my hair is like naturally like wavy, curly, and I haven't been putting product in it, so I feel like I look even more disheveled because it does look and get frizzy throughout the day, especially when I'm having my heat flashes and I'm freaking out. So maybe I'll put myself together. I just look crusty. I just really do. I'm sorry, guys. Yeah, let me go take care of my face. I don't want to do my makeup because it's not like I do my makeup every day, but I feel like it'll just put me in a better mood because I'm just... It's nice that it's quiet and... It's hard when babies start moving too. ever since she started rolling, it was like once she figured out rolling, which came like a week or two after she was supposed to start rolling, after her like 3 month mark, she started rolling like a week or two late. But after that, there's no stopping her. And she's a very smart baby. She's a super, super smart baby. But yeah. I didn't really get to enjoy my coffee while we were eating brunch together. I also have to go clean the back patio too, where there's gonna be ants everywhere. But my mom is really chill. She's super understanding. I'm really grateful that I do live with my mom right now because I don't have to worry about, like, except for making Erin's meals, because I'm fine going out without eating. I don't need to eat. I could care less. I could starve. I could starve at this point. I probably should starve myself because I'm very, very overweight. I'm just kidding. That's so bad. But for me, I'm good, like, not going... Like, I'm good with, like, small things to eat. Like, I'm not a person that needs to, like, cook for myself all the time. But now that Erin's around, it does push me to, okay, let's cook breakfast. Let's cook brunch. Let's cook, you know what I mean? Instead of just going out for food or post-meeting something. But it's really great. And I'm really happy I moved in with my mom. I don't know what I would be doing if I was still in my studio apartment with a baby by myself. Like, nobody was coming home at 6:30 to help me or to, like, give me a break or to let me go take a shower. I don't know what I would be doing, to be quite honest. So my mom usually comes home around 6:30, and she usually helps me. She'll cook with Erin. That way I can, like, either get back to work and work for a little bit longer until dinner's ready, or I could go take a shower, or I could sit there and just scroll on Instagram for a little bit. Like, I could just, like, have a moment to just be Priscilla, and it's, like, really nice. I don't have, like, before I became a mom, I didn't have the greatest relationship with my mom growing up. So now that I'm a mother, just, and she's my only, like, parent now, I'm so thankful for my mother. I remember when I was pregnant, she used to tell me, like, you know, I'm not gonna raise your kid for you. You know, this is your responsibility. You know, this is your child. There's people out there with parents who only want to be grandma or only want to be grandpa. They don't want to do extra. They don't want to be like another caretaker or like a third parent. They literally just want to come see the kid for a little bit and then disappear, you know, until like the next holidays. And I honestly thought because she would every once in a while have that conversation with me that she would help me, but she wasn't going to like literally like do everything for me, which she still doesn't. But I look at my mom in a different light now that I am a mother. I'm gonna get emotional. You know, my mom wasn't a perfect mom to me. And, you know, there's things to this day that I wonder, why did she do that to me? Or, like, why did she do, like, just things. It makes me think about a lot about, like, my own childhood with her. But seeing her being a grandmother and just how attentive, how involved she is. And it's not just, I don't think it's just because I'm a single mom and she knows I need help because I'm doing like a two-person job on my own. I literally think it's because that's how much she loves my daughter and she loves me. So having her just come home after she finishes her work day, it helps so much. Even if I spend like 12 hours of, you know, busting my ass, like just having like from like 6:30 to like 9, being able to like breathe for a little bit, it really feels really, really good. And, you know, my mom, she still works. She had a couple weeks off during the holidays, which was really great. And it was so helpful. It was really nice being able to just focus on work for those 3 weeks and not feeling like I was walking on eggshells with my job, because I was like 100% delved in You know, my mom still wakes up at 3 a.m. every single day, and she doesn't come home till 6:30. And she's been doing that for the last 10 years. And I can imagine. I don't know how she does it. I don't know how she's been doing it. You know, at one point in time, my mom was a single parent too, with not just one kid. It was like three. And I just have like a new like respect for my mother. She saw everything that I went through the last almost 2 years, and the fact that she offers to help. It's not, I never have to ask my mom to help me. She offers to help. It's to the point where I have to tell my mom, like, hey, back off, like, I don't need your help, or like, no, you know what I mean? Because she's that hands-on with my daughter, and it's just really, really beautiful to see. And I don't know if I'll ever be half the woman my mother is, because she's been through a lot too. And now that I'm a mom, I'm just like, the things that I used to like hold against her or hold resentment towards, I'm kind of like, who am I to judge her? Because I could only imagine what was going through her mind as a mother making those decisions. But yeah, I'm just rambling at this point, enjoying the fact that she's asleep. And I guess she's pretty knocked out because I'm being kind of loud and she's still asleep. I have to go change my socks because Erin spilled water on me. And I don't think I'm going to change just in case she eats again later. I'm just going to rock out the same outfit. And probably, I don't know, guys, should I do my makeup? I need to go check my emails first before I even think about doing my makeup, but I just know I look crusty. Sorry. I never claimed to be the most beautiful girl in the world, but yeah, I think I'm just gonna go freshen myself up a little bit. There's cameras in this living room, so I'll just be watching her from my phone, and yeah. That was a nice conversation. I hope what I said made sense to at least one single mom out there.
We'll say that although being a working mom is the hardest thing that I've ever done in my life, I feel so lucky. I know it probably doesn't look like the most glamorous job, especially with the way that I'm looking recently, but it is the most rewarding. That's not a lie. I have been lucky to see you do so many things for the first time because I've been fortunate enough to be with you at all times since you've been born. And I think about all the moms who have to separate from their babies freshly postpartum just so they could go back to work.
Yes,
they don't get a whole summer of maternity leave like I did.
Wow.
And sometimes single parents, they oftentimes not go back to one job, but two, or even have to pick up a third job right after giving birth. I couldn't really imagine being away from you all day and possibly all night. I hope that life never puts me in a position where I have to sacrifice time away from you. Because being a parent and spending time with your kids, especially when they're so young like you are right now, it's such a luxury. And I kind of feel almost bad. I feel like I've been a spoiled brat just complaining throughout this video. But this is all I know as a single mom. I don't know any different. And postpartum is hard, especially when you're doing everything physically and emotionally on your own. I can understand why many married and single women become depressed and even suicidal around this stage of motherhood. And I won't lie, I felt that way very recently. I didn't want to wake up one morning because I just wanted to tell the world how unfair and cruel it can be to single mothers like me. How cruel people can be. I just want to say, it's not fair. It's not fair. You don't know how much I do every day for my daughter. I don't want to be strong all the time. And sometimes I need help. But I don't think anyone could do this job or be the mother that I am to you. I don't think I'm replaceable. So, whenever you watch this back, Erin, I just want you to know how proud of you I am. Look at you. You're so smart. You're so big. You're growing up so fast, right in front of me. I am the luckiest woman on earth that I get to grow old with you.
To celebrate the end of another work day, and we're one day closer to Friday. It is a little bit later in the evening. It's actually almost 9 p.m. Baby Rin is actually not in the room with me. After Grandma came home, that's usually when she starts cooking for my little brother and stuff, and for me too. But you know, she's still a mom too. She still has like an 18-year-old who's going off to college this year. But I'm really thankful for my mom, because she is only one person, and she's probably my main village. She is my village. And just her help alone, it makes a world of a difference. And sometimes I'm like, wow, I should really just get like a nanny or a babysitter and just spend the money and just, you know, do what I gotta do, because it would make a difference throughout the day. But I'm just not there yet, financially, and I'm just saving all my money for a nanny and a babysitter for when I move, because I know then I'll actually need it. So, you know, I'm trying my best to just ride it out. And you know, there's a lot of good days. Probably 98% of the days are awesome. You know, I got really lucky with Erin. She's a really good baby. But that 2%, you know, they're rough. They're rough. They're few and far in between, but they do occur. I'm going to pour my Olipop before it goes flat. I love this. There's a Japanese soda I used to drink growing up. It was like in a blue can. And I think it's from Calpico. And it was like a cream soda flavor. And this is the first drink outside of the Asian market. And they sell this at Target. This tastes almost exactly like that Calpico cream soda that I used to love growing up. So it makes me very nostalgic now that I'm a mom. So I like to treat myself to it. It seems to be pretty healthy. It has prebiotics, botanicals, and plant fiber. You know, I'm not a wellness junkie, but why not? I mean, it tastes good. So, cheers. It's amazing. But yeah, so having my mom, like, voluntarily, like, out of the kindness of her heart, because she doesn't have to, like, she'll take Erin as soon as she gets home, and she'll be like, hey, I'm gonna cook. Go do what you gotta do. She does that because she wants to, not because I rarely ask my mom for help first. Usually, sometimes I'm like, well, whatever gets done by 5:30 can probably wait till Erin's asleep, or if not, I'll just wake up, you know, another hour early and just like play catch up that way. But I'm really happy I ended up moving in with my mom during my pregnancy, because she has just been my rock in more ways than one. And you know, me and my mom have always had like a tumultuous, we had like more growing up, just because of things that occurred in my childhood. We had a very tumultuous relationship, and you know, and eventually I went off to college and she was living here, and then I moved here. And then we kind of like repaired a lot of our relationship, and you know, I'm not perfect and my mother's not perfect, and I think I understand her a lot better now that I'm a mother. And you know, I think at the end of the day, every mom is just doing what they think is best, and I just have a new respect for her that she stepped in as a grandma and as my mother, and just having her help me for like
even if, like, I can't get any additional work, just having someone, like, that luxury of being able to say, like, my mom is watching, like, grandma's watching Erin right now, so I can go take a shower, you know, as a single mom, like, shit, like, that is a luxury, because I think about, like, the single moms who don't live with anyone else, it's just them and their babies or their kids, like, multiple kids, and they don't got time for nothing, and they're not just working one job, or they're not even just, like, even if they're working one job, they're not working from home, like, they're working, like, in a physically intense job, and I think about that, and that's why, like, I always say to myself, like, damn, like, there's someone in a worse position than I right now, and they're a single mom, too, so, like, I feel like I don't have any room to complain, because in a lot of ways, I am, like, privileged, and, I try to remind myself of that on the harder days. But yeah, grandma came home and, you know, she does her cooking after she comes home. And Erin's a pretty low maintenance baby for the most part. So like 9 times out of 10, she's just going to hang out near you. And, you know, grandma adores her. And so grandma's name is Ellie. Sometimes I call her Ellie. I know that's a little, people are like, you're calling your mom by her first name. That's just the type of relationship I have with my mom. But lately I've just been calling her grandma because Erin's around now. So yeah, I should call her grandma and not Ellie. But, you know, so yeah, when she got home, I was able to go take a quick shower. And then I actually went to go get my eyelashes fixed. I was kind of like due for a fill. I don't know if you guys like noticed throughout the video, like my eyelashes probably look janky. And like one thing about me, like especially now that I'm a single mom, is like if I'm gonna be stressed the fuck out, can I at least look presentable or like somewhat cute? Like to me, like let me at least get my eyelashes done. And like for me, like that's just a part of who Priscilla is. So like I can't let my eyelashes go. Like, maybe you guys don't like the way I look with eyelashes, but I like the way I look with eyelashes. It makes me feel good. It gives me, like, confidence. I feel like when you have your eyelashes and your eyebrows done, you just look, like, 100 times better. And that's just, like, any girl or any guy. So, yeah, I was able to go quickly. And I say quickly because it's literally, like, not even a 5-minute drive from my area. My eyelash lady is down the street, and so is I call her my friend in my head, but the lady who's been doing my threading my eyebrows since like I moved to California when I was 22. So I was able to get that done, and you know, I took a shower, I'm like moisturized, I just feel good, I feel better. And to me, it makes just like a world of a difference, even on my crappiest day. It just makes me feel better, and I'm like, I could be stressing internally, but like if I can at least just like look good on the outside, like that's all I really care about. So I was able to go do that. That took like about an hour because my eyelashes weren't that bad. So the fill only took about 40 minutes, then the eyebrows. And then I was back by like 7, I want to say. Yeah, I was back by like 7 and 7-ish, maybe a little bit before 7:30. And then I just came straight to take Erin from grandma. Grandma was tired, so she was already in bed, showered. So was Erin. She was already, like, in her PJs, good to go. So I just kind of was like, I felt bad because I feel like I don't want my mom to ever feel like I'm taking advantage of her or just, like, you know, like, I'm, like, tired of being a mom, like, or I'm trying to, like, neglect my responsibilities. So I just came and took Erin and, she did fall asleep here, and then I was like, oh shit, I have something due that needs to get done by X date, X time. So, you know, it just made the most sense for grandma to sleep with her. And because I'm also going to the gym at 2 a.m., so either way, I'd rather not wake her up in the middle of the night. So they're going to sleep together tonight, most likely, and I'll be on the computer. But yeah, this is how most nights end. I feel very privileged to at least have my mom who comes home at the end of her work day and, you know, helps me. And just, like, having that hour and a half, 2 hours
to myself just to do something I want to do. Because if it's not going to, like, get my eyelash filled, it's, like, just taking a shower or just, like, being able to come upstairs and, like, clean up my room or continue working if I need to. It just, as a single mom, single parent, it just, I just feel so, so blessed. Because in December, I really did have a lot of hard days. Erin was sick. I was sick. We were just all, me and her were just going through it, and I don't want to get emotional. At the end of the day, like, I don't want to come off like I'm complaining or that I'm looking for sympathy, because at the end of the day, this was all a choice. I chose to become a single mom. I chose my daughter over anyone else. And so I think all my content that I've put out since postpartum started, it has been more like educational. I wanted it to be more educational and informative, and I just want to give you a glimpse to my motherhood as a single parent. You know, every parent's different, everyone has their own circumstances, especially as a single parent. I mentioned earlier that you know, unfortunately, I will never be receiving child support. That's just not an option for me anymore. I thought it would be. But, and this is advice I got when I was pregnant, and I just thought there was going to be a different outcome. And so I don't want to put a price tag on my daughter's well-being and her emotional and physical health. And with child support, a lot of times there has to come compromise. It becomes like a bargaining thing, and I don't want to bargain my daughter's childhood and potential trauma like that. And, you know, if I kind of have to beg for help, it's not worth it in the end. And I kind of had to learn that the hard way at the end of 2023 and into 2024, that as much as like the set amount of money I was supposed to be receiving for child support would have helped in even like maybe one day out of the month or something like that, having someone, or, you know, just someone like a relative, like paying them for their time to like come and help me on like maybe one day out of the month while I work and just can like work 8 hours straight uninterrupted, is kind of what I visualized, and it just is not ever going to be a thing. And that is also a decision that I made, because I don't want to lose my daughter. I've made sacrifices since the day I found out I was pregnant. And, you know, unless, like, you're a mother, in particular, like, in very specifically a mother, especially a single mom, like, we're doing a two-person job on our own. Being a parent is a full-time job. So I'm doing, like, a two-person full-time job, like, two full-time jobs on my own, on top of my actual full-time job that pays the bills. And as the months have progressed, and I've been at work for almost half a year now, I've been back from maternity leave for almost half a year, almost 6 months, I want to say. You know, a mother's will and perseverance, it's unmatched, I feel like. I do everything I can, especially now, to like keep my job, because it's a good paying job, it's a well paying job, and it has really great benefits. And I've set myself up for this before even Erin came into the picture, and I don't want to lose my footing with my colleagues or feel like I'm not capable of being a mother and a working mom. Like, I feel like those are two different things. And add like being a single mom on top, like, it's a lot, it's hard. And If it doesn't look hard, it's because single parents make it look easy to be real. And it is what it is. I wouldn't be saying that if I wasn't, I'm saying that because I am a single mom. And any single parent out there working not just one, not just two, but three, four jobs, and holding it down for their kids on their own, no village, no child support, like we're just built different. And those type of women got my respect. And I only hope to be half the women those women are out there. I hope I'm making sense. I'm trying not to get emotional because I just got my eyelashes done, and I don't want that energy to flow into where Erin is sleeping. But yeah, I hope you guys are kind of getting the gist of what I'm saying. Lately, I've been talking with my therapist about how I think a lot of my postpartum anxiety comes from knowing I don't get any child support, knowing I only have my savings to rely on if you know if shit hits the fan, knowing that I could lose my job, and what am I gonna do then, like how long will it take me to get myself back up, would I be able to provide for my daughter. I get real anxious about that now, because everything feels like it's on the line now. And I feel like only single parents know that feeling, like feeling on edge. And it amplifies on the harder days with Erin when I'm just home alone with her, and I got meetings, or I'm behind, I get scared. I'm like, oh shit, my boss is gonna call me asking me why this isn't done, or what's the hold up with this, I fucked up on this. I'm they know I have, my own family now, but they don't know I'm a single mom. To them, I'm just an employee at the end of the day. If I don't meet productivity levels, and I don't keep up with the way I was working before I went on maternity leave, you're wasting our money. We could find someone who's gonna do it right the first time, who doesn't need a flex schedule and stuff like that. So I think that's where my postpartum anxiety is at right now. It's just feeling not on edge 24/7, but on the hard days I'm like, oh shit, tomorrow my boss, I'm gonna wake up to my boss saying what the hell is this, we need to have a meeting with HR. That will really break my heart, because anyone who knows me in my personal life knows how hard I worked for the job that I have now, and how lucky I was to even get this opportunity. And even when I first found out I was pregnant, I was scared to say something to my director at the time, who's now retired. So it was barely a year and a half in, maybe. And I don't know, I just was scared that there was no room for me in the decision that I made to become a single mom in my field. So yeah. But I'm just rambling at this point. By this time, I just I try to reflect on the day, and I try to think about all the good things that happened with Erin throughout the day. Like if she did something new for the first time, or she did some, I am working, guys. My screen just went, it's been more than 15 minutes, I think. But I just try to take this time to kind of just collect myself, and just get as much work as I can now, because she's asleep. And any parent knows, any working parent who works from home and has their kid at home with them knows that when they're asleep and there's any minute of downtime, typing away, that's that's what we gotta do. We got every second counts when they're asleep. So yeah, I do what I gotta do. If I gotta stay up the whole night just to make sure I don't fall behind at work, I do it. And I don't think I've ever complained about it. I'm a night owl anyway, so it's not like I was gonna be sleeping if I wasn't on the computer anyways. But yeah, I hope this gives you a little bit more insight as to what my life is majority of the time, because this is my full-time job. This is my only job, which is what I'm also blessed for, is that I still kind of have the weekends to like hang out with Erin. I still have that time, and like after work to dedicate with her. I don't have like a second job like a lot of single parents have to like pick up, and I hope I can hold off on a second job for as long as possible. I'm also like super anxious about like my annual review coming up right before my birthday. I think I have to do my self-evaluation in February, but I know the annual reviews get done in March. It's also my birthday month, but yeah, so I'm just like praying that I pass. I would like my annual raise. It would put me like in a better spot for 2024 into 2025. And yeah, this is pretty much what it's like for me working from home as a single mom. If my mom's watching this, thank you grandma for helping me every day after you come home. My mom, she also has a full-time job, and she wakes up at 3 a.m. every day, and she's done that for the last 10 years. And now I get it. I used to like, that's what I tell myself too. Like, there's some days where I'm just like, I want to sleep in. Like, it's like, I'm risking my daughter's stability. Like, not, like, me sleeping in for, like, 10, 30 minutes, it feels like I'm risking my daughter's stability and my livelihood for, like, 30 minutes of sleep, so I just don't do it. Like, if I gotta stay up, I'm gonna stay up. If I gotta wake up at 2 a.m. to go to the gym so I could start working by 3:30, I will. I'm not playing about my daughter, and, you know, I try not to make excuses for myself, because I think about people like my mom who wake up at 3 a.m. when realistically she didn't really need to. Like, my stepdad makes good money. She could easily like chill out, especially now that she's older. And she just, you know, my mom's a Virgo. She's very independent and prideful, and she'll never do that. And she also wants to buy a house too. So, you know, she's working as hard as she can too, because I want to buy a house too. Spoke that into existence, and so like I'm working my ass off for my daughter, because I feel like she deserves the best. And you know, grandma wants to buy a nice house, so Erin has somewhere pretty to come and visit for a vacation and stuff when we move, and you know, have her own backyard where she can frolic when she comes to grandma's house. You know, so we're all trying to get there at our own pace, in our own time, and you know, I think that God saw what I went through in my previous life before I was a mom, and He saw everything that I went through, and He saw what I went through emotionally and spiritually throughout my pregnancy, because it was pretty traumatic. My pregnancy was pretty traumatic, and it was beautiful, but you know, it definitely left like an impression on me, and I think He just saw like what that did to me emotionally, and I think that's why I have such a great, happy baby. Like, everyone who sees Erin or spends time with me and Erin, they're like, wow, like, you have such an easy baby, or like, your baby, why is she so happy all the time? Like, she never cries. Hardly ever cries. She's barely fussy, like very rarely. I think when she was sick, she was like the fussiest I've ever seen her, and I think that's why that month was like really hard for me, because I've never seen my daughter act like that so far. So I think I've been blessed, and you know, single moms, like single parents, whether you're a single dad or a single mom, like, I get it. Like, I have so much respect for us. Like, sometimes I'm like, I don't even know how I do it. I don't even know how I'm functioning with, like, no sleep, you know? But we do it because, like,
our kids, like, and anyone who talks shit about, like, single parents, like, you could go fuck yourself, like, for real, like, you don't know. I don't want to hear none of that fucking red pill, like, bullshit on my channel, like, yeah, you chose this, but why did you open your legs? Like, shut the fuck up, like, for real, shut the fuck up, like, you have no idea, like, you couldn't do what we do. Let me put it like that. You could not do what we fucking do. Like, you couldn't do it on your own. You couldn't. Like, single parents, like, we're just, like, built different. And I definitely have grown a backbone in my postpartum because, like, I'm never gonna let someone disrespect me just because I'm a single mom. Like, ain't gonna happen. Like, it's just not gonna happen. Not on my watch anymore. Like, maybe in my past life, I used to turn the other cheek to a lot of stuff. But when it comes to me as a mother, like, you can call me every name in the book, but I know I'm a good mom. I know I'm a good mom because I make sacrifices for my daughter every single day. And I put my daughter first. And I wake up because of her. And I get shit done because of her and for her. And I think that's any parent in general. But, like, a single parent, like, we don't have, like, a fallback plan a lot of the times, or a village, or the emotional, physical, financial support. And so, like, the fact that we find a way and, like, we persevere and we just, like, we try to build a life for our children to, like, be happy kids and better ourselves all at the same time, like, you could never. But to any single mamas watching me right now, I'm proud of you. We got this. I truly believe in the saying, like, God doesn't put us through anything that he knows we can't handle. And, you know, if we can't take it 15 minutes at a time, let's take it day by day. And, you know, we're going to figure shit out because we always figure shit out. And honestly, like, I feel like ever since I became a single mom, not only has it, like, realigned my goals in life, like, as a woman and as a mother, but it's also, like, given me, like a weird sense of, like, motivation and, like, ambition. I feel like anything's possible. Because we kind of make the impossible happen on a day-to-day basis, like, like, working from home, it sounds nice. Oh, you get to be with your kid all day and work from home. Like, no. I wish it was like sunshines and rainbows, but no, it's like a juggling act. And it's like the days go by fast because we don't got time to, like, take a piss, or, like, we don't have time to, like, check the time. Like, we're just, like, go, like, trying to, like, maximize the hours in the day, like, get the most out of them, like, so the days, like, I do kind of like that they go by fast, like, the days, like, I wake up, I, like, do what I gotta do, and, like, next thing I know, it's, like, 1:30, I'm, like, oh, shit, it's 1:30, like, that was fast, and it's because you're just, like, go, like, there's no time to, like, wallow and, like, I don't know, feel bad for yourself. There's just no time for that. There's just no time. So I kind of like that about being a single mom. But that could just be, like, me. That just could be a me thing. I don't know. I'm really proud of you. And you got this. I know that's, like, super basic to say. But I want to make it, like, I'm already talking for how long? 30 minutes? Out of how long is this video going to be? God knows, because all my videos are long. but I don't get to talk to a lot of people on a day-to-day basis. I don't talk to anyone on a day-to-day basis, besides, like, my coworkers, maybe. So it's kind of nice to, like, sit down and just, like, cut it up with you guys right now, because I don't got no friends or anything like that. I mean, I have friends, but, you know, no single mom. I mean, do I? Oh, yeah, no, actually I do. Sorry. Mom brain. But, yeah. Yeah. This is what working from home as a single mom is like so far. And I'm kind of glad I made this video now and not... I filmed this video on two other occasions. Once, I think around October, when Erin was maybe 3 or
almost 4 months. And then again, almost at 6 months. And honestly, I am so happy I never posted those because you guys would have probably shitted on me. It's like, yeah, that's so bad. Like, because I look back at the footage and I'm like, nah, this is too easy. This is not what working from home with an infant baby is like. I'm really happy that I waited. I'm really happy that I waited a little bit because both times that I filmed this previously, Erin was not like, she was not mobile, as in like she hadn't yet, she was delayed by like a week, like 2 weeks, 3 weeks almost, like she just wasn't rolling over. And we chopped it up to like, oh, she's a chunky baby, my baby's chunky, okay, she's thick like her mama. So you know, we were just like, oh, it's because she's thick, like, you know, she's a thick baby. So but when she started rolling over, then she started doing more tummy time. And when she started rolling over and doing more tummy time, she figured out how to sit up. And then when she figured out how to sit up, I thought it was like, oh, she's gonna start crawling next, no big deal. I'll just put up gates everywhere and we'll keep her confined. Nope. She skipped crawling and she's like, she crawls. Like she speed crawls too now, but like, she learned how to crawl a little bit, but she was too lazy to, and we think it's because she's a chunky baby. So she knew how to crawl. She's like, like this is too much work. So she just from one day to another started standing up, like propping herself up on her two legs. And then now she speed crawls. Like she went back to crawling and blah, 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 blah. And now she's like super, like she's like a super baby for real. And once a baby becomes mobile, and I didn't believe it. I'm like, oh, they're exact. And I have a good, well-tempered, her disposition is, like, good, like, isn't fussy, and it's hard. You gotta make sure they don't bump their head, that they don't fall back, that they're not, like, Erin loves to put everything in her mouth. She loves throwing things. That's her favorite thing to do. Like, it's insane. Like, once... It just, like, was, like, a snowball effect, too. It didn't happen, like, slowly. It was just, like, bing, 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 bing. Like, and then, like, that's when work from home got really hard. And then, also, as they get older, 1 month to another, like, there's so much change in a baby. And, like, once those wake windows become more, like, spread out apart, and then they're just not even taking any, like, she's down to, like, she's in between 2 to 3 naps. Like on a bad day, she's still taking 3 naps. On a good day, she's still taking 2. Like she'll take 2. But yeah, like even the wake windows too, and like the feeding schedule changing, and then you gotta incorporate solids. You gotta make time for that. Like it's insane. It's insane. That's why I'm just like, the fact that people talk so much shit about single moms in particular, like you guys need to go fuck off. Like for real. Like you really couldn't. Like, you could not do what we do. Like, there is no fucking way. Like, and it's always the people who don't have kids. It's always the people who don't have kids. But whatever. It's always the people who don't have kids, aren't a daddy or mommy to nobody, always talking the most shit. Like, it really is. But yeah. I'll let you guys go. But thank you guys so much for over 700 subscribers. I think you're a little bit over 700. You know, these videos are made for my single parents out there, and I appreciate every single one of you who like sit down and like leave a comment, watch even a minute of this, because you know my videos are long as fuck. And leave a comment. If you guys follow me on my Instagram channel, you guys know that I'm in my weight loss, like I'm trying to get back to my hot girl era that I was at like before I became mommy. But yeah, we're doing a little like health like journey over there, and it's been fun, and I've been making a lot of new friends on Instagram because of it, and I'm super thankful. And I'm tired, but there's long-term reward.
And just like that, the day is over, but it's not all at the same time. I think for any mom, the day is never truly over. But But this has been my life the last few months. This is what my life for me consists of, at least Monday through Friday. I know 2 days have ever been the same since I came back to work, and I don't really say that in a bad way. Every day kind of feels like a new side quest where I gotta figure out how to make it through. And as Erin gets older and reaches new milestones, it's like another curveball's being thrown at me and I gotta dodge it. I think any parent can relate where everything in life just feels heavier after having kids. For me, my job, I don't know if my leadership understands how grateful I truly am. And every night, especially on the later nights where I work into the next morning, I end up laughing a bit when I look at the time because I'm surprisingly not miserable. I think as a single mom, as hard or overwhelming as it may be on a day-to-day basis, I'm just so lucky I have a job, if just not for another day, because it means I can continue giving my daughter everything I need on my own. And I can sleep when Erin goes off to college. This video is dedicated to all the single parents around the world. We got this.